Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Yuri Bender of PWM, and I would like to welcome you back to the FT headquarters in London for the latest in our expert series of video interviews. Today, our subject is leadership and innovation in digital wealth management. To contribute to this discussion, I'm delighted to welcome Bart van Haren, CEO and co-founder of InvestSuite. Hello, Bart.
Thank you, Yuri. It's great to be here.
And Joyce Chu. Joyce is Senior Wealth Tech Solution Specialist at InvestSuite. Wonderful to have you with us today, Joyce.
Thanks, Yuri. We're happy to be here.
In our first chapter, we will look at democratizing wealth management. Now, Bart, several financial firms have designated 2022 as the year of retail investing. Others are more skeptical about this label. How do you feel the COVID pandemic has really changed the situation and helped the fintechs and digital wealth managers become more involved in the whole ecosystem?
Thanks, yeah. So first of all, I think COVID undoubtedly has caused a massive increase in new people to invest. There are two big trends that I noticed with COVID. One is an amazing amount of new customers, and second, much younger. And the latter is very, very important. Mm-hmm. When you look at the average age of online brokers, and this is really globally, they dropped dramatically.
But I'm glad you're talking about this generational change, Bart, because it's not only the brokers that are getting younger, it's the clients that are getting younger. So if we look at this next generation of clients, I mean, they're interacting on message boards like Reddit, they're exchanging information about hedge funds, they want to fight hedge funds, they see them as an enemy now, they see themselves as a force for power, a force for good. And we're seeing the war in Ukraine as well. We're seeing these investors exchanging messages about how not to invest in Russian companies, to make their investments more ethical. Is there an entire mind shift that we're seeing here, a mindset shift?
There is a bit of anti-establishment that has always been there, but even more so now. Like, let's take on the big guys. Even if you look at the GameStop story, there was no fundamental story behind it, but it was more an expression of us against others. So, and I think that will only, in my view, continue. I don't see any signs that is slowing down, on the contrary. But two, also investing with a purpose. And that brings us to the whole ESG story, of which we can elaborate later. But that's a very important point. It's not only for the younger generation. Let's be honest, there is a myth that older people are not interested in that. That is not true. Research shows that. But definitely for millennials and other generations, investing with a purpose is definitely there and will also like not go away.
So if we've moved on from traditional bonds and equities, if we want to encompass environmental investments, private markets, private equity, and these non-fungible tokens as well. Is this a realistic goal for investors to be able to access all of these types of investments?
It's quite realistic because if you look back in the day, in the past, it was, you know, everyone, access to just individual stocks wasn't accessible. And that didn't seem realistic before. And then, of course, we introduced, you know, funds, stock trading. We introduced ETFs so that people could get diversification. Fractional shares, which we touched on earlier, was huge in democratizing wealth management. And so now we've come a long way there. But what investors are really looking for now is not just how can I make more money or save more? How can I also make an impact with my money, or what? How can I invest in things that I care about? And so thematic investing or personalized investing, I think that technology can really help us get there. There's now technology that can be, you know, tech-driven investment selection by the client, where they can select, you know, certain preferences, whether it's sustainability, E, S, or G, and, you know, align their investments there. with respect to the private equity market. There's now platforms like Moonfair that allow access to specific sleeves of private equity and digital assets like tokenized and blockchain. I mean, the goal really there is to increase transparency, improve liquidity, make things more consistent, cost efficient. So there's now a lot of platforms that exist, NFT platforms, crypto platforms. And what we're seeing is that the incumbents will also soon follow through. But the responsibility there is to make sure that we're doing this in a way that guides and protects the investor, because we are providing them, yes, with more choice, broader asset classes. But the main thing, again, is financial literacy. And at the end of the day, protect the investor so that the capital markets can continue to be used and we can continue to find ways to invest.